Hello everyone, we'll see today class on analysis of continuous beam by three moment equation. Okay, this is very simple method to find out the analysis of continuous beam, but you can solve only for the three spans. Okay, three span like span ABC, BCD, like that three span you can solve. Okay, for further more spans you have to take the other method. So this is given. So suppose this is your span ABC and it has L1 I1, L2 I2. UDL is acting on the beam, and this is your how the theta will be acting at the joint B. Based on this Z1 and Z2 section modulus, you have to solve this, or you have to derive this formula. Okay. So this is your area bonded. This is your bending moment for this each span, and for that bending moment you have to find out area, that is A1, and X1, that is a centroidal distance. Similarly for the other region, then this is a bending moment diagram example. So from this you have derived this equation. Okay, the equation is nothing but MA into L1 by I1 plus 2MB into L1 by I1 plus L2 by I2 plus MC into L2 by I2, which is equal to minus 6 A1 X1 by I1 L1 plus A2 X2 by I2 L2. Suppose you have I1 and I2 as same, that is equal to I, then this I will be eliminated. So this might be your formula. Okay, using this formula for each span you have to solve, and you have to solve the equation and get the value of joint moments. Okay, here first you are calculating this joint moments directly, that is MA, MB and MC. Joint moment you have to calculate. From that joint moment, then you can consider, or you can find out this VA, VB and VC. Okay, reactions you can calculate. So this formula is nothing but first moment you have to multiply by first length, and second moment you have to multiply by 2, and it is the summation of the two lengths. Then third moment multiply by the second distance. So which is equal to, this is A1 X1 you will get from the each span bending moment diagram. Okay, this is your area 1, then X1 by L1, A2 X2 by L2. Here X1 is from this end and X2 is always from this end. Okay, so you have to find out the distance, calculate the distance, centroidal distance from this end and from this end. Later it will be easy for you to solve the problem. Okay, we'll see first in the first problem. So this is your given problem ABCD. Okay, so 8 kN, 10 kN, 12 kN per meter is given. These are the distance. So this distance is total is L1, this is nothing but L2, and this is L3. Okay, here from the derivation we know that at the moment at the joints will be a free end will be 0, that is bending moment always at free end it is 0. So MA and MB is 0 and MB and MC is unknown over here, so it is not equal to 0. That we have to calculate using this three moment equation. So first for that, just find out what is A1, A2 or X1, X2. Just find, calculate that and keep in the side. Then you can substitute in the formula and just solving from formula, you get the value of MB and MC. So first step, take each span, consider this span AB. This is your moment, 8 kN, it is acting exactly at the center, point load. You know the maximum bending moment value for the point load. You know how bending moment is exactly at the point load. So it will be triangular variation if the point load is there, and at that point, where point load is acting, there you will have maximum bending moment. And that maximum bending moment is a formula is nothing but WL by 4. So WL by 4, just substitute, W is 8, L is total is 4 divided by 4. So that is nothing but 8 kN meter. Okay. So next to find out A1 and X1. So this A1 is nothing but total area of the bending moment diagram. So whatever, after drawing this bending moment value or finding this value, just consider this area. So this is nothing but your region A1. So calculate this area. This is a triangular force. So area for triangular force is half into base into height. So half into base is 4 meter, height is this, that is 8. So half into 8 into 4, you will have area that is 16 meter square. Next, centroidal distance. This is exactly at the center. It is equidistant. So you can directly get the centroidal distance half of the length. So half of length is nothing but 2 meters. So x1, x2 will be 2 meter from both the end. Okay. Next, we'll see span BC. So span BC, again it is a point low, but it is placed at the, it is here it is equidistant, but here from the left it is 1 meter, from the right it is 3 meter place distance. So just take it as A and B. For this, the variation will be same, triangular variation, but your maximum bending moment formula will be, for centroidal distance you have WL by 4, for placed apart you have WAB by L. WAB by L, A is nothing but first distance, that is 1 meter, this is B, divided by L is nothing but total distance. So W is 10 into 1 into B is 3, divided by total L is 4. So you have this bending moment at this point, that is nothing but 7.5 kilonewton meter. Next step, find out the area. So this will be your area here. So this area is nothing but A2. And find out the centroidal distance. So here centroidal distance is, this will be your x1 and this is your x2. Okay, find out that. Okay, next is A2. A2, again it is a triangular variation. So area is half into base into height. So half into base is how much? Total distance is 4 meter into height is, that is 7.5. And A2 is nothing but, A2 you have 15 meter square. Okay. Now to find out centroidal distance, that is you have centroidal formula for this x bar. You have A1 y1 plus A2 y2 divided by A1 plus A2. A1 A2 is nothing but area for the each section, and y1 y2 is nothing but your perpendicular or centroidal distance. So first A1 is this area and A2 is this area. So find out for that. A1, the half into base is how much? It is 1 meter. So 1 into height is 7.5. You will take centroidal distance from this. I will calculate from this end. Okay. So centroidal distance for triangle, just I will draw here. So this is your triangle now. For triangle, centroidal distance is, from here it will be from the right angle region, it is 1 third of B. From other end it is 2 third of B. Okay. So B is nothing but your distance. Total distance is B. So here, now as end is this, reference point is this. So it will be nothing but 2 third of B. So 2 third of 1. Next, plus this region, half into base into height, half into distance is how much? 3 meter into 7.5. And centroidal distance for here, again triangular region is here. So it is, here it is 1 third of B. Okay. But we want up to this. This is your reference point. So here you have 1 third of B. Plus B, you can write it directly, that is B is 3. But you have to consider up to this point. So this distance is 1 meter. Is it clear? Next, divided by total area. Total area is half into 1 into 7.5 is A1 plus half into 3 into 7.5. This is nothing but your total area. You can take directly total area is nothing but 15 meters square. Have calculated there. Directly you can divide it by 15 or you can do step by step also. So x bar here I have marked it as from this side it is x1. That is nothing but you will get 1.67 meter. Okay. From the other end that is nothing but x2. So total distance is 4. 4 minus 1.67 is nothing but 2.33. Okay. So here this will be 1.67 it is x1, this is x2, so it is 1.67 meter and here it is 2.33 meter. Otherwise, if x1, x2 is confusing, you can write it as left and right, that will be better. So you can write it is here as L, for right region you can write is R. Similarly, L and R. So it will be better while considering. Okay. Once now for the last span, span C D. Here it is UDL. Distance is 5 meter. Load is 12 kN/m. So what is the maximum bending moment for UDL? It is the bending moment for UDL is parabolic. So suppose it is exactly again it is in the center itself. So you will have it. So this is your bending moment diagram for the UDL. And the maximum bending moment formula is WL square by 8. Okay. WL square by 8. So it is W is nothing but 12, L is 5 square by 8. Just calculate and get the value. You will have 37.5 kilonewton meter. Okay. So now find out A3 and XL and XR for this. So A3 is nothing but for this bending moment formula area is 2/3 of BD. So 2/3 of B is total distance 5, D is height that is 37.5 and A3 is 125 meter square. And here it is exactly the center. So yeah, XL and XR equal to half of the distance 5 by 2. That is nothing but 2.5 meter. This is your centroidal distance. Once this is done, next directly write the formula, substitute accordingly and get the value of bending moments MB and MC. Okay. So first consider first span. That is span ABC. You have to consider three moments. So you have to consider three points, three joints. That is ABC, first joint. So formula is nothing but here I1 equal to I2 equal to I3 equal to I. Everything is no moment of inertia variation. So throughout it is I. So eliminate I. So first, just first moment MA into L1 plus 2 times MB into L1 plus L2 plus MC into L2, then minus 6 A1 X1 by this. Here you have to consider from previous problems, here it will be XL A1 X1 by XL by L1 plus A2 X. From this For this, you have to consider XR from the other end. According to your, while deriving, we have considered that itself. So we will consider accordingly. For left region, you have to consider L. For right region, you have to consider R. Okay. This is a formula. And here, L1 is equal to how much? Next step. Just see. MA is 0. These are known. So, L1 is equal to 4 meter and L2 equal to 4 meter. Okay. Now, substitute. MA, this is 0. So, you have this 2 times MB, L1, L2, 4 plus 4 plus MC into 4 equal to minus 6 into, here A1 is this. So, A1 will be 16 meter square and here A2 is equal to 15 meter square. This. Okay. So, A1 is 16. So, 16 into XL. XL for this A1. XL is 2 meter plus A2 is 15 and this from this XR you have to consider. So, XR is how much? 2.33 divided by, here it is divided by L1 that is 4, here divided by L2 that is 4. Okay, just simplify. So, is this understood? A1 is 16, this span you have to consider that is 16, here you have to consider XL, XL is nothing but 2 meter. Then A2 is nothing but 15 meter square and you have to consider XR in this. So, XR from this it is 2.33. So, it is 2.33. L1 and L2, this is your equation. Equal to, solve this, you will get minus 100.425. Consider it as equation 1. Now, next span, that is span BCD. Okay, span BCD, here MB, MC and MD you have to calculate. MB is nothing but 0. So, first MB into L1 plus 2 MC into L1 plus L2 plus MD into L2 which is equal to minus 6. First write the formula XL by L1 plus A2 XR by L2. Okay. Now substitute. Here L1 is nothing but this span. So, 4 meter, L2 is nothing but this span that is 5 meter and A1 is nothing but this A2 now that is 15 meter square. A2 is nothing but you have this how much? 125 meter square and XL and XR accordingly find out. So, MB L1 is 4 plus 2 MC 4 plus 5 plus MD into 5 equal to minus 6. Here it is 15 and XL from this XL now left side you have to consider that is 1.67 plus 125. Here XR, XR is 2.5 divided by here it is 4 and for this it is 5. Okay, so here 15 into XL that is 1.67, XR from this it is nothing but 2.5. Okay, just simplify, you will get 4 MB plus 18 MC. This is 0 equal to, you'll have minus 412.575. Equation 2. Now solve equation 1 and 2 and get the value of MB and MC. MB will be minus 0.57 kilonewton meter and MC will be minus 22.79 kilonewton meter. Okay. Next we'll see. We'll draw SFB. Now find out this reaction VA, VB, VC and VD. Okay. So for that, see here whatever we got, that is minus. So it will be Hawking bending moment. This is your Hawking bending moment. That is how much? 0.57 kilonewton meter. At C you have, again it is minus. So it is Hawking 22.79. Accordingly you have to consider now. First consider span AB. Okay. Draw free body diagram of AB. Here you have BA and this you have divided. So just consider BB 1 for this. And here you have moment. This is 0.57. And this is your 8 kilonewton meter. This is 2 meter. Okay. Now summation VB1 equal to 0. Moment at VB1 equal to 0. You have clockwise as positive. So you have, this is clockwise. So VA into 4. This is anti-clockwise. 8 into 2. And this is, it is anti-clockwise, so plus 0.57 equal to 0. Find out VA. VA is nothing but 3.86 kilonewton and VB1 is nothing but total, that is 8 minus 3.86, that is nothing but 4.14 kilonewton. Okay. Similarly, consider next span. Span BC. Draw free body diagram. 10 kilonewton. This is BB2 and here it is BC1. Okay. And it is, here it is 0.57 and this is 22.79. Okay, distance 1 meter, 3 meter. Similarly, consider this moment at VC1 equal to 0, clockwise as positive. So you have this positive, so VB2 into 4 plus 10 into 3, then this is anti-clockwise, so minus 0.57, this is clockwise, so plus 22.79 equal to 0, therefore VB2 equal to, we have 1.945. kilonewton. Therefore VB is nothing but VB1 plus VB2, which is equal to, add up 4.14 and 1.945, you will have 6.08 kilonewton. Okay. Next consider last span, span CD. this is VC2, this is VD, and this is 12 kilonewton per meter, distance is 5 meter. So summation, moment at C equal to 0, clockwise as positive you have, now this is VD, minus it is anticlockwise, so 5, and this is plus 12 into 5, into 5 by 2, and I have not shown here this moment, here it will be 22.75, here it is 0. So this is anticlockwise, so minus 22.79 equal to 0. So find out VD. Therefore VD is nothing but 25.44 kilonewton. Once known, so summation Y equal to 0 upward as positive, that is nothing but VA plus VB plus VC plus VD equal to total distance, that is 8 plus 10 plus 12 into 5. Okay, therefore now VC is unknown, everything is known, so VC is equal to, the distance is 78, total load is 78, so 78 minus VB minus VA, VA is how much, 3.86, VB is, total VB is 6.085 and VD is 25.44. Therefore VC equal to, VC will have 46.76. Okay, once this is known you can find out shear force. Now I'll show how to draw this BMD. For no need of calculating this bending moment, because you know already the value of bending moment, so you can directly take down. So this is your reference line. You know this for span AB, for this bending moment was triangular variation, and this here it is, and for this it is same. So this maximum bending moment you have found out, that is for this it was 8. Maximum was 7.5 and here it was all positive, that is nothing but 37.5. Okay, now you know this joint moment, that is a negative point value, at this point it is 0 and at this point it is minus, so just mark it here, here it is nothing but minus 0.57 kilonewton meter, and here minus you have 22.79 kilonewton meter. So just okay, so this is positive value and this will be our negative joint displacement, this part. Or you can, after finding this, you can do again and get the value. Or this is a simple way how to draw the BMD, and your elastic curve will be, here it is 0, so this is like this, and here you have negative displacement, so hogging. Again it is positive over here, again it is negative, then it is 0. This is your elastic curve. That's all. Thank you.